Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. This is the fourth video and final video for what I'm asking you to do with the data that has the rating of several cereals from two different manufacturers, G and K. In the first video, I had you find measures of center and measures of variation and for the two different cereals and put those in there. For the second video, we took all the data that we were given. We made class limits for the entire data set of both cereals. We put bins, upper bins of the upper class limits, and use those bins to create a frequency distribution table and a histogram. In this third video, we separated the F and the G, F and the K frequencies, and then created a bar graph that had double bars, a histogram, excuse me, that had double bars, so that we could then compare and make decisions about which cereal actually has been getting better ratings. In this video, we're going to make a frequency polygon. And to do that, I'm going to use the same frequencies that I had here. I'm combining both cereals, not two separate frequency polygons. So here I'm going to take this, I'm going to do Control C to copy it. And then I'm going to come down and paste it. I want to paste it below my data. I don't want to be messing with my data when I add rows or something. So I'm going to paste that. Just click on one box and then hit Control V. That's going to paste that down there. And I also want to add a box because I'm always using midpoints for a frequency polygon. How do I find the midpoint? Well, all I have to do is take add the first to the last of the in one class limit, add those together and divide by 2. So 20 plus 34 is 54 divided by 2 is 27. So I have 27 as a midpoint for that particular class. And then I can just add 15. I know 15 because that's my class width. So if I add 15 to 27, I get 42. And then if I add 42 plus 15, I get 57. And if I add 15 to that, I get 72. And if I add 15 to that, I get 87. And if I add 15 to that, I get 102. Why am I adding 15? Well, a frequency polygon, we want it to touch the axes, the x-axes on the both ends. So not only am I going to add that, I'm going to go back up here and I'm going to click on this and I'm going to right click and hit insert, and it's going to insert an entire row. This is why I wanted to be below my data, so I didn't do anything weird over there. I know you can avoid that, but I'm going to subtract 15 from 27 and get 12, and that's also going to have a frequency of 0. Remember, I didn't have anything lower than my class limits or higher, but I just want to make sure when I do that that I have that settled. I want that to actually be centered. I don't know why I did that. And then I want that to have a box around it just to look nice. Okay, so now what I want to do, I've highlighted all that. What I want to do is I want to insert a line graph that I'm going to call a frequency polygon when I'm done with it. But it's not going to look like that at first. So it's all highlighted. I'm going to go up here to insert, and I'm going to choose line graph, and I'm just going to choose this one. Now notice that I don't have anything that looks close to a frequency polygon there, which is fine. But I am going to change it to look like that. So what I'm going to do, actually I didn't want to include class limits on that. So if you have a mistake like this, just hit backspace. That'll get rid of it. Let's just do, I just want the frequency in the midpoint. I don't want the class limits on that. So I'm just going to highlight those two columns and then go back, insert my line graph because I just wanted those two. And now I'm going to make that look like a frequency polygon. What I want is, you see how it's considering both of these as data? And what I want is the midpoints to be along the bottom. So while I'm in design, I can click on select data. And then I can get rid of the midpoint as something that's actually being graphed on there. And then I'm going to edit this, and it's going to ask me what I want for that. And I'm going to go ahead and highlight this row right here. And that's it. Now I have a frequency polygon. Notice that it begins at 0 and it ends at 0. My midpoints, the frequency of the midpoints, 27. My midpoint is 27. The frequency is 16 for that. For 42, and then 87 is actually my last midpoint, but then I also have the 102, which then shows that. And I can always change the name of anything. Let's just, I don't know, maybe I'll just call that frequency polygon. And then I can add things in if I want. I could add whatever you want into that. You can dress it up how you want, but there's your basic frequency polygon. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.